topic. Welcome to the next topic. And in this topic, we will going to discuss some of the basic functionalities of the Julia environment about how you can write some numbers or how you can write your first program, which is always a Hello World program. And then we will look at some of its command through which you can easily use it. So first of all, about this interface, which has been given over here, a small introduction of Julia, that you are in a Julia interface. Its documentation is available over here. For type, for help, you need to type question mark. And for package help, that means like Python, if you are coming from that background or if you don't know about anything, packages. So packages is nothing but the libraries through which you can import functionality. So for example, if you need to create a chart, you need to import, first of all, you need to add the library and then use it in the Julia. Similarly, if you need to apply the some data set related manipulation, you need to add the library in Julia and then use it so that you can do that operation. So that's a package help if you need. It's basically the bracket, the closing bracket and the question mark. So first of all, let's try and enter some values. So maybe let's say I enter 7, which is a numeric value. As you can see, if I print 7, it gives me the output 7. If I press, let's say 7 plus 8, like any normal mathematical operation, then it gives me the output 15. That means it understand what operator you are giving me or giving to the Julia. So 8 minus 5, which is a subtract, the subtraction operator which I am applying. So it gives me the output 3. Very, very basic, straightforward. And as you can see, you can do the manipulation over here. Similarly, I have 12 multiplication by 5. The only difference is here I don't have the spaces. Here I have the spaces and here also I have the spaces. So what I'm trying to show you that it doesn't really matter within the calculation if you are giving space or not. However, the recommendation is that you give the spaces. So if I enter, it gives me the output of 60. And similarly, you have the division operators. It's basically divide the 12 by 6. And if I enter, it's 12 by 6. And you have 2 cap 2, which is basically it takes the square and gives you the 4. Similarly, 20 cap 20, then you can get the output, which is pretty lengthy. Okay, so just to clear up this entire screen, you can press Control L. And Control L is basically cleaning up whatever you have entered so far. So let's go ahead and write the Hello World program. So if you think like the numeric numbers, if I enter the Hello World within the double quotation, because strings, this is basically a string, which string needs to be entered always in double quotation. So if I enter this, it gives me the output Hello World, right? If I enter this in single quotation, Hello World, it gives me the error. So this is basically more of an evaluation string. This is basically the string which we need to type it out and get the print off. So that's one way how you can write the Hello World. Another way is you can use the print command, print Hello World, and it gives you the output Hello World in a properly formatted. However, if you see, you have the double quotation, that means it is giving you exact output. Or if you just write the Hello World over here, it won't understand that, right? So either in this way, if you want an output like this, or properly use the print command to print the Hello World. One last thing I will tell you over here in this topic, that we were doing the operation like 7 plus 5, which is giving us 12. But let's say for some reasons you don't want the output, what you can do is 7 plus 5 and press semicolon. Once you press the semicolon, it does the operation, but it doesn't give you the output. In scenarios when we will look, which we will look at later, that there are functions or there are commands which gives us the output, but we just don't want the output and we want there to Julia to store it over there. In that cases, we just add the semicolon at the end of the expression and doesn't give the output. All right, so That's about it in this topic on how you can enter the numerical data, perform mathematical operation, and write your first Hello World program. You saw that two different ways in which you can write that program. Now in the next topic, we will look at some of the commands related to the Julia, about how to operate Julia.